bis ab. Yeah, I'm just fully committed to every time I've got 250 scrip, I buy more energy modules and I re-roll my fucking chainsaw, my second chainsaw. I've got the suppressors one will do for now, but I want that vampire anti-armor deal or something like that. Do you know what I mean? I want something big. With the vamp, if I can get the vampires one, that's it. I'll give away or sell off my two heavy weapons that I often keep around. A shopping trip. I've got like 29 grand just before I had a couple of people at my store. I'm like waiting to log off so I can join this. I hate shutting the place down whilst people are at my place. So I'm waiting for them to leave, and then one's like, oh, I'll buy 5,000 of these and I'll buy 4,000 of these. Oh, fuck's sake. No, they bought it. I've got like 29 grand. I don't like being up there. I like to try and keep myself around about the 10 grand mark, so I can buy stuff if needed. But when I'm at 30 grand, people will quite happily drop 10 grand on bullets. Like Soy was saying the other day, why do you do it? It's so easy for people to make bullets. And I do it because people buy them. It might be easy for me to make a fuck ton of bullets, but other people. And mostly the people I have low levels come by like 100, 200 bullets here and there, and I have the high levels come and drop 15, 20 grand at a time. It's nuts. private parts. Oh. Oh, yeah. Goose experienced being killed by another player for the first time yesterday. We're off, loading, launching, trying. We shall see. See, one thing I've noticed is, like, as I play 76 through the night and I look at different people's camps, there seems to be a dedicated UK crowd who are like focused almost entirely on building camps. Because there's, I wouldn't say it's like a difference, but like as it gets to like 9, 10 in the morning, my time, and I start looking at some of these camps, they are incredible. There's this guy, I went to one earlier, he was just down the road from Grafton Station, and he was built on the train tracks, and he built his own station, and it was fucking better than Grafton Station. It was so good, so detailed, so well put together. Nice. Well, that makes me jealous. I think I've got a cryo bed now. I think I've got the plan to bought the plan for that from somewhere. Cabrio energy felt so flash saber. I'm gonna go GTO GP. Missed that too. Well, if the name comes up with Rallycross, we're screwed. If it comes up with GP, we're in luck. GP, hey. Oh. Well, there's the answer to Architect's question. Did Tent Station make it? Kind of. Oh, fucking hell. I don't like these flat bits, of course, like that, without signage. You don't know that you're doing a hairpin until you're halfway through the hairpin. Yeah. Really fucking give us some indication that this is going to be like a 180 degree turn. Any clue at all that you'd have to do a massive fucking sharp turn? Arrows. Just need a couple of fucking arrows on this course. It's a gorgeous lap, but you need some indication of what's about to happen. Because at the moment you're just racing blind the whole time. Yeah, you're not following the road, obviously it's its own course, so you just gotta guess. Essentially, the checkpoint will tell you something, but it doesn't tell you. You know, you start doing that, what you think is a 90 degree turn, and it turns out to be, oh, it's actually a fucking hairpin. And you're not prepared for that. And the only way to prepare for that is to brake excessively for every corner, just in case it's a hairpin. Just need some arrows. So if the creator watches this, just whack some arrows in, dude. Give us, you know, you look at any race course in the world, there are arrows indicating the strength of a turn, how sharp it is, how tight it is, whatever. Because you know, we're on a green track with green layout, like background. We're just not getting that information from the course. This right here needs something to tell you it's a hairpin. Like this one, you can kind of see. Cause you can, ah, what the fuck? The car's spin around completely. Swerving the camera like crazy, trying to see what's coming up. I don't know, it feels like it's an unfinished race. It's, the race has been built, but it hasn't been. There's no markers, there's no indicators, there's nothing telling you about the course as you're driving the course. Some warnings, some signs, some indicators would go down an absolute treat on this race. The fact that it's a windy course and all that kind of shit, that's fine. It's just, let us know. Oh, for fuck's sake. God damn it. Right, randomly faster, same car as me. Busted out of that straight, what the fuck? Wait till lap 5 to get your car this much faster than mine. What the fuck was that? Jesus. Yeah. Sorry, I didn't realize I was. I've just been kicked from the session for being idle too long. Are you fucking kidding me? I'm not an article kid. Kid for being idle. Well, I'm stuck in the clouds now, so. So the game freezes, and it freezes long enough that it starts kicking people for being idle. That's just fucking stupid. Oh, you didn't do anything for the last 2.5 minutes. Yes, because your fucking game didn't load. What do you want me to do? Well, I have landed. Let me know when you guys like. Hold on, Rockstar. I mean, at this point, you may as well just restart Eggerjack from the next job. How many have you got? Looked like a lot were leaving before I got kicked. Sixteen on the scoreboard. Wasn't it like 25 starting the race or something? You're in a loop, I think, of someone lagged out and froze it, and then people were getting kicked. And as is usually the case, you're normally waiting for the person who got kicked to land in a session. And as more and more people get kicked, you're just waiting for the every time someone leaves, you're waiting for them to land before you can move on. But then someone else leaves, and blah blah blah. I did manage to confirm that a long time ago, but. You are genuinely waiting for the person who left to land when you're on those frozen screens. Oh, it's a decent car on the podium, so I can be guaranteed to not win this one. Clothing unlocked, gingerbread. I mean, what the fuck's that? That tells me nothing. What's gingerbread? Same. Oh shit, there's a thunderstorm. What's that? My internet's lagging out. Oh no, fuck. Oh shit. No. Pistol death match. No, you get your ass in here. Don't make me do this alone. I need to be with someone who can relate to my bitching. Neither do I. But... Oh, so it's a gingerbread mask. That's what I want. Okay. Are you telling me, Aggrejag, it was easier to make the shape of little round discs than it was to make kings and queens and pawns and knights and rooks and bishops? Disgraceful. So I'm gonna make a chess. I'm gonna make a checker set. Can always picture that the idea and then the oh fuck. I might be wrong. Exactly. Yeah. You're like, I'm gonna make a chess set. Oh fuck no, I'm not. I'm gonna make a checker set. And I fucking will make a horse out of these props. Jesus Christ. Two floors, so it's 3D checkers. Damn. Oh, this week the dress-up scene was dead stand-up comedian. Can you guess who I am, Michael Jack? I can't get him to smoke a cigarette right now, or else it'd be a bit more obvious. Picture him smoking. Oh yeah, full GTA experience. Now we need a stunt race with lots of black screens to really get that full experience going. Someone trolling a banger race. And we need one person in this lobby to be a hacking, cheating piece of shit, just running through, killing everyone to get that full GTA experience. Ah, it's Bill Hicks. Ooh. I may be wrong, but I'm like 99% certain that you don't need an apostrophe in that vendettas. It's a plural, not a possessive. There we are. I'll make that my one complaint about the job. Out the way. Now I can't say anything else. Without muting myself first. Oh, shotgun. Oh. I shall stick with the pistol, I guess. Headshot. What happened? That was a headshot. Oh. Shot him in the head. Get it behind us. Oh, behind us. When I get what the big deal is, oh, it's a 50 car garage, big whoops, the fucking office has a 60 car garage. So does the nightclub. And, you know, with the nightclub, you get a fucking nightclub, and with the office, you get an office and the ability to do heists. What do you get with the 50 car garage? Yeah, well, I don't get the big deal and why it costs so much. All headshots, all headshots. Thank you. I don't understand how shooting someone in the head doesn't kill them. Unless they're shooting me in the head, then they kill me every time. Every time. Every single time. Oh, headshot actually killed someone. It's a miracle. It's for Christmas. 12 kills, 12 deaths. Wait, we won that? We've been losing like the whole game. I don't understand. Did we just win at the last second? Not losing by much, but I'm sure we've been losing the whole game. Ravers, TSO. Supers. Okay. Tells me nothing. We'll go Krieger. Play it safe. Yeah, I think it is. It's pretty decent as well. I think it's comparable to the T20, not so much the Krieger and stuff, but it's decent. You don't? Okay, that was so confusing. How am I gonna not trigger any of those checks? Fine, I'll go round again. What the fuck? Didn't trigger either of them. I managed to go around both of them. How the fuck I managed that? It's mainly because like I just drove in and there was no floor. I didn't know where I was going. I had no idea what we were supposed to do in there. It was just a turnaround. It's quite simple, but it wasn't too explanatory. Bumpy. I'm going to come off this spiral because I suck at them in third person. That's just to show I can do it in third person, but we're going to stick to first because I prefer it. I think he could just outrageously cheat the last bit, just jump off to the finish line. Really feel that you could do that loop turnover and then just drive down to the checkpoint. I think it needs a checkpoint in the air or on stunt somewhere. I'm pretty sure you can. Yeah, but it comes back. I'm pretty. Why don't you do the loop over? Have a look. Did you just do that? Did you just jump off? Oh. Yeah, you just see that. That's probably why that wall's there to the right, actually, because there's no real other reason for it. There's a wall on the right. There isn't one on the left, so it's not protection. It's to stop you jumping down. Yeah, you could probably. Yeah, all right. He's put some protection in there. I thought about that the best day, and it probably would have been faster through the stunt. I wouldn't have enjoyed that turnaround with it. Oh, shit, that's not good. Oof. Could you run the timer, please, Agrajack, if you can? Later. I want to make a fresh coffee and stuff. Let's get started on that. Cheers, Aquatech. I mean, you might not like the Tempesta, but you got fifth place in it, buddy. Certainly did the job. Rough style with a lot of dirt, like your mum, then, yeah? Oh, right. It's not a lot of dirt. Oh, it's cleaned up. Cool. Oh, yeah. I've done that, a rally cross race before, and there's just like one sliver of tarmac in the entire race. It's a rally race. It's just what it is. That's not a retinue. I love the Tropos. I was always an Omni guy, and then I started playing the Tropos a bit more and was just like, you know what? I like that it's flat. Filthy. In it. I mean, they say no news is good news, and that's true. Just don't look at the news and your day will be better. Good news. And you open up the news, it's all death and hate and. I learned something today about GTA. Yeah, it's a nice course. If you're on a motorbike and you're falling, you can negate any form of fall damage by opening up your radio in game. Open up the radio, you don't take any fall damage on a motorbike. Also, an answer to why people sometimes survive explosions that they just shouldn't do. If you've got like a wall that's like 90 degree angle, and you line one edge of the wall with sticky bombs, and then you go and cover on the other edge of the wall right next to those sticky bombs, that 90 degree corner will save your life. You won't take any damage. Because GTA physics. There's this like YouTube Shorts guy, and he like myth busts essentially, you know, all these things about GTA, and some of them confirmed, some of them are busted, and those ones got confirmed. Like, damn, it actually does work. Oh God, yeah. That's why I'm desperately hoping that when GTA 6 comes out, it'll come out pretty quickly with a creator mode, because the game itself, I'm not that fucking interested in, to be fair. It's okay, I'll probably play it, you know, whatever. it's going to be more about this aspect of things. So, this is what kept me playing GTA in the first place. They'd be mad too. Yeah. It amazes me though, there are large portions of GTA players out there who A, don't play online, like ever. They just do all story mode shit relentlessly. And you get other people who never, and I mean never, play custom jobs. They're like, no, I don't play custom jobs. And you're like, why? No, I don't play custom jobs. Don't like them. What do you mean you don't like them? It's like saying, I don't like food. Have you tried all the food? Seem to be in this pretty solid and firm 8th place. I can't seem to get any distance on the 7 in front of me, and I'm way ahead of the one behind me. Well, it's Aquajack, okay, I won't say way ahead, because probably not that far ahead, but... Oh, actually, looks like 7th made a mistake. It very much is. Oh, don't start out, you bastard. Let's go. Oh, this is, oh, shit. Lancia. It's not a Lancia Delta. It's a. It's gonna piss me off. I'll find out in a sec. It's a gorgeous car. It's an absolutely gorgeous real life car. It's a lovely rally car. Let me just type in Lancia and it will show up. Stratos. This bad boy right here. That puppy. Very, very successful rally car as well. Came out in the '70s. World Rally Championship winner, 74, 75 and 76, 3 years in a row. The Lancia Delta F was also a nice car, which I don't know if they've got a version of in Delta F in Degrali. I don't think they have a version of that in this game. Oh, this is fun. Oh, I think he's put some parachutes in now as well. Yeah, parachutes on top of the central tower. He's put in the description all the stuff that we've discussed over the time we've played the job in the past. I mentioned about putting parachutes. We were all talking about how the person needs to go through the bubble, not the car. Which, Agrijog, if you're still watching, I think you are, that's the issue with the orientation checkpoints in air races. Your plane needs to go through the blue bit almost exactly. Or at least your body needs to be in that blue bit of the checkpoint in the right orientation. And if it isn't, it will flash red at the last second. I think that's because they've removed them, so they've become, I don't know, finicky, more finicky. Way more finicky. Parachute, you got to land there though. I love that. He's giving us parachutes, but fuck me, you've got to be as skillful to get the parachutes as you do to. They lost, is it? Allow me to get it back. Do you know I got 2 points? I got B like right at the beginning and they never got it. Ah, shit. Oh, fucking hell. Duh. Ah, fuck. No one's got even got D. Damn. Go on, land on there. No? Okay. Land on there and get a parachute. Pretty much guarantee getting there. Oh, move, 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 move. Ah, fuck. I was adjusting to try and avoid him. Not even a straight line now. Oh, God, my foot, my body went through that. I angled it so my body went through it. Oh, it's always been an E. That's the one that no one could get, but now it seems no one can get D even. Just can't get that D, let alone that E. It's a thought. Who knows? And Jennifer watching the streams, just shaking his head like none of them could even get D. Determined to hit that level 300 and fall out this week as well, this weekend. Oh, 296, something like that. You saying you don't believe in people's right to choose, Doc? There we are. Angry joke, I'll ban you later, Doc, because you don't believe in people's right to choose. All these Rocket Voltic stunt race creators now that there's 300 props, I can go back in and make it so that we never have to push to L3. Just give us more boosts. I like it when it's like this, not when you're just constantly looking for the right moment to hit the boosts. Camera. Suddenly saw a bunch of cars overtaking each other. I was very confused. Oh, fuck off with you. What the fuck? There was absolutely no reason to spin out there. What the fucking forwards? Landed perfectly on four wheels and just started spinning. The fuck? Gaining places the whole way through the race and then just got absolutely fucked on that landing. Oh, now what? Oh, what the fuck? Christ. Now I'm the wrong way round in this bit. Oh, fuck me. Oh, you better fucking make that jump. Fuck you.
over there.
Okay, this landing bell. Oh, fuck me over again. Got back all the places that I lost from the last landing on this prop. Oh, fuck off! Fucking forwards! Jesus fuck, that landing is horrible! Lands and fully starts drifting for just no apparent reason. Did I see you were playing Ghost of Tsushima recently, Aquajack? So, how are we getting on with that? Recently did a full run through all the DLC and everything like that. Again, it's a delightful game. Not for a while, huh? Well, then never mind. Oh, damn. I've got a box of ammo for my pistol, have I? Oh, I actually have a pistol. Okay. got a lock on someone. No dots, I can't see where anyone is. Oh, there's an assault rifle. Who's shooting at me? There's no one there, what the fuck? I still got the... Teammate, but obviously it doesn't even show your friend, your teammates on there. So you run around chasing someone for a while just to find out your teammate. You try and shoot them, give away your position. Is that a friendly or is that an enemy? Oh, it is an enemy. Fucking hell! But that is that an enemy? Yeah, it is an enemy. I mean, that's the thing. I can't tell if someone's a friendly or not. This is a free for all. Oh, it's a free for all. For fuck's sake. I looked. I pushed triangle to view teams and it showed me a team. Fuck me. Oh, God. Oh, well, then I'll just stand here and people can kill me and then that's done. I've had my three lives and I've done my bit. I'm loving this. Why can't I aim on them? Why can't I aim on them? What the fuck? Wouldn't lock onto you at all. It's like you're not fucking there. No, because I've locked onto other people. Oh, yes. Sorted. You can just commit suicide 5 times, job done. Minutes. Perfect deathmatch for me is RPGs versus RPGs set to one life because it'll be over in like 6 seconds. It's the best kind of deathmatch. One that I haven't got to play. I don't mind this so much because, like I say, I'm dead. I can sit and watch now. I don't have to do it for the full 10 minutes. Really, thinking about it, the only jobs I really like in LTSs are RPGs versus something or snipers versus something, neither of which have lock on. Yeah, but that's what I like, is the snipers or the RPGs, the where you haven't got to deal with GTA combat bullshit. It's just you're firing at a vehicle. Running around, running, gunning in GTA is just bad. It's just bad. Laggy, it's inconsistent. Doesn't make any fucking sense. You shoot someone 6 times in the head, it doesn't kill them. They shoot you once in the foot and you die. Problem is GTA isn't a dedicated racer, it isn't a dedicated combat game. It's a bit of everything, which means it's not great at any of it. You know? It's not like the makers of Call of Duty and Gran Turismo got together and made a game. Do you know what I mean? So we're gonna have incredible racing physics and incredible combat physics. That's not what we've got. So big draw to this game for me has always been the creating aspect of it. I rate the combat very, very low. The race physics are questionable at best, but doable. Shoot that yellow barrel, Agrajack. See what it does. No, the one next to you. Sees you. I swear to God, Agrajack, if he shoots that barrel and it kills you. There we are. Got away from it. Hold up. Don't understand that either. I had a score of 2, and yet I came higher than people who had scores of like 10 and 12. I guess I just lasted longer than them. God damn it, I told a really good joke then and I was muted. Johnny got kicked out of class today. The teacher asked him, if I gave you £20 and you paid £5 to Joanne, £5 to Jane and £5 to Katie, what would you have? Apparently, three blowjobs and enough left for a kebab was the wrong answer. Tippy waiters, I'll be here all week. I did like that one I posted in the Discord earlier, though. You really have to hand it to blind prostitutes. Oh, I thought that was a wall. It was, oh God, it's doing this camera thing. Oh, I hate it when people do this. Oh, stop it. Stop forcing my camera low. It. Oh, fucking rubber walls. Is this a wall? Oh, it is a wall. Okay. And that's the other thing. Now that he's done that, every time I see that thing, I don't know if it's going to be a wall or if it's going to be something going over the top to force my camera down again. The oversteer on this thing is ridiculous. You go to take wide to take a corner and you turn right and suddenly you just hit the corner because you turn so sharply. Oh, I don't like this camera nonsense. Very distracting. It's just that one section that has them. I don't know why they're there. Why's he done it? People did that a couple of times in stunt races. Who is? Sorry? Oh, nice. I think it looks really good. The critics apparently have panned it, but, you know, whatever. Yeah. Do you know what? Yeah, I mean, that's the thing, you know. Lots of them have had all kinds of different reviews. I've watched all the Marvel films up to, you know, Black Panther, Wakanda Forever. And there has been one that I didn't particularly enjoy. The rest of them, I've enjoyed. Multiverse of Madness. If I'd have watched it before Everything Everywhere, I may well have enjoyed it a lot more. But I got massively spoiled beforehand by watching an incredible multiverse film to then get Multiverse of... like three scenes. It was, yeah. And it was all leading into like the horror aspect, which is not my cup of tea particularly. It's what it is. But almost every other film I've really enjoyed, the TV series. My God, the oversteer. How I keep hitting that, I don't know. Because I'm going so wide around it. And then I turn, do the starting to turn right, and it just, like, does a 90 degree straight into the concrete. Oh, these fucking props. Very distracting. The fuck did you come from, Astro? Nowhere near me, and all of a sudden you just come out of fucking nowhere. The only person near me, behind me, was Flensation. The fuck did you come from? Don't slide. Off-road, and I don't turn the grave out. God, those are skinny checkpoints. Oh, okay. okay. But you can still... That's what I was saying, yeah, tiny checkpoints, you've got to be careful. I don't know. Because I said so. I don't know. Oh, fuck me, that was a bit of a surprise. What? What? No fucking way did he miss it. Did he trigger it? No fucking way did that guy in front of me trigger that. He was outside of me, and I didn't trigger it. They're still going. He says I'm in third, so I don't think they've realised. Oh, there they've realised. Tiny little checkpoints. Right, good job. You're going to have to, after reviewing the stream, you're going to have to write me a 500 word essay on how the fuck you triggered that checkpoint. When you were kind of almost wall riding then, you were nowhere near it. And these checkpoints have been vicious to people on this race. Oh my god, why is that there? What the fuck? The wall is angled so deeply into the ground that you can drive onto it as you come around the corner. But you can't see it because there's like leaves in the way. That's a tree there, Agajack. I shouldn't have talked shit. I'm about to definitely make a massive mistake. I was set that. There it is. Yep, two wheels. Oh, these need to be taller. I don't like the fact that you can go around the corner and end up on top of the wall quite easily. That's tricky. Oh, shit. Okay. Taking a right. No, I was fully prepared to gun it up there. Where are we going now? This way? Okay. Turn, you bitch! Fucking turn! Christ! Oh, fuck off! Ugh. Flipping up onto its fucking roof. It's checkpoints. These checkpoints are too skinny for the course. I don't know why he's made extra skinny checkpoints. Because it's completely against everything you know as a racer in this game. It's like Bandito checkpoints or something? I don't... Please, Christ.
Oh, what the... Oh, my God. There's nowhere near steep enough an angle to do that on pretty much any other vehicle. And I don't know how Karima would jump up, jump at the chance to go up on two wheels. And that. Fuck me, that was close. Oh shit, we're going that way. Fucking hell. Christ. Was someone following me then and didn't react to what I did quick enough instead of reacting to the road? I almost missed my turn in and I swerved at the last possible second, and the person behind me also swerved at the last possible second, but a little bit late. I don't know who it was. Oh, I'm scared to think it's going to flip up on two wheels again. Don't you consider it, you little bastard. Baby step in this van, dear, just to make sure it doesn't flip. Go, 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 go! Go, 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 go! Now, am I right in thinking that that was defaulted to contact and you changed it to non-contact aggrojack? Because that race would be very problematic on contact. You just nudge someone away from a checkpoint real easy. With a super skinny checkpoint like that. Oh, it's a bug. The checkpoints. Okay, Bandito checkpoints. Oh, it's a new bug. Yay! Still got three jobs left. We're 2 hours. Is it me? Is we going really slowly? I don't seem to recall any job in particular that sticks out as taking a long time or anything. Oh, another pistol death match. Are you kidding me? Okay. Is it limited lives or something? Yeah, we're losing more people. I mean, there's only 8 of us, Agrojack. We don't need to do 10 minutes. I'm just putting that out there. I mean, you know, it's just something we're normally doing in diversity or whatever is like 8 or less. It goes for even King of the Hills, I'll put them on 5 minutes because there's just 8 of us. And all it takes is one or two people to lag out, and all of a sudden it's just a massively unbalanced game. So 5 minutes. Is it more than that? Even if I don't like it, you know, you've seen I'll put the pistol death matches in diversity mix. I don't enjoy it, but I put me into 10 minutes. But if it's low on numbers, yeah, last one, it'll be the best of the last five, and then that'll be that. Oh, okay, they're not where I thought they were going to be. Oh, you can climb up there. Okay, I just thought it was a wall. Oh, what the? Okay. Who the fuck is shooting me? Yeah, apparently. Oh my God, how many do you want in the head, Mandible? How many do you fucking want in the head? All fucking headshots, just relentlessly pounding him into his fucking head and nothing. Stop using a pea shooter sometimes. Gonna say fucking hell, Flynn. I had to drop on you then. How dare you? So close to turning around and killing me. I was like, no. Oh, but with all the lagginess. At least I can shoot you one with one bullet, Agrajag. That makes me feel better. I can't kill anyone else with one bullet, but I can kill you, apparently. Oh, what's that fucking health pack in it? There it is. Yeah, that's great, he says. Up. Oh, fuck me. All right, I'll just fall quite a long way down to my near death. Well, not really, but. Sure, I shot you in the face then, but whatever. Shot me whilst I was rolling then. Come on, I've got quad damage. I need to use it. I need everyone to be together. Just there for me to shoot. No? Okay. So one and one again. 8 kills, 8 deaths, 8 points. Unlucky. He's one of the monarchy. He's one of these people who call it simple and easy and have it not be simple or easy. We'll see. Time to get your badge out. that off. I even braked a touch still.
Nope.
Whoa, what are you doing? What the fuck? Oh, yeah, just spit out on a straight. Why the fuck not? Oh, and again, we're going slidey, slidey, okay. Give it a shot in third, but it's a twisty bit, so I'm not going to be a fan of. I'm confused as to what jobs left because I don't remember. Wait, am I looking at the wrong? No, I'm looking at the right list. I don't remember doing an LTS, but I don't remember doing Tom's Leviathan race. I'm missing something. Oh, yeah, I do. Oh, it was a limited life death match. Okay. That I remember now. Oh, last man standing. I looked at the symbol for last team standing. Love this race. It reminds me of my parkour that's in this same area. That everyone kept fucking cheating. I really liked that parkour. That I know we're doing a U-turn because there's a sign saying U-turn up ahead. That's how you know it's a Tom race. Attention to detail. Unlucky. Oh, fuck it. Oh. I feel much less a fool. Thank you for the immediate gratification there, Agrichek. I come around the corner, fucked it, hit the wall head on, and then Agrichek comes and does exactly the same thing right next to me. It was glorious. I'm like, oh, fuck, I've lost first. Oh, never mind. Less funny for you, Agrijag, but you know, I liked it. Oh, are you already in Fallout, Doc? I mean, yeah. That magic number 900 gave it away. I'll be there soon. Wait, the fuck away from me. Just learning from my mistakes. Delightful. Ooh, bit of water there. I avoided it, but I'm sure that'll cost someone a place somewhere along the race. Nope, not hitting that wall. No, no. Get to fuck. You're not taking me on the left. Fuck off. Fuck off. Fuck off. Fuck off. Oh, you prick. Well done. Less than 1/100th of a second. On the fucking line. How dare you? The polite thing to do would have been dab the brake. Oh, wow. Very close race. Well, there was like a two-horse race for first and second, another two-horse race for third and fourth. Pretty much neck and neck. Oh, of course I would. Of course I would. And if you believe that, I've got a bridge to sell you. Oh, the broadways. Wow, the broadways were way slower around. Damn. Evil Genius is now spectating. You're a bit late there, buddy. Oh no, he was racing. Never mind. I thought you just joined. Never mind. I am a fool. Oh, it was you in that last race. Because I was saying that. I mean, I caught my mistake, but I guess you were reacting to me rather than the race, and so put you like a step behind on that bit. I remember that. I swerved at the last second because I was like, oh shit, we're turning left. It's when you get that, especially when you're racing that close to someone the whole race, you get that tunnel vision, don't you? And you end up focusing on the car rather than on the course. Yeah, been there. Noted. Anytime Angry Jack's behind me, dump it into a wall, he might follow me. The tunnel vision. Oh, thanks for watching. Thanks for hosting. Wait, what? You took me at the last second? I didn't notice that. You took the playlist? I was like 10 points ahead. Huh? Oh, well. Never mind. Close game.